Okay, so then the question is, what are the rules for rounding off? Right? And a lot of students make mistakes with that, so this is where you should pay attention. So first rule is, if the digit to be dropped is greater than 5, the last written digit is increased by 1. So for example, 12.6 is rounded to 13 for 2 digits. So if somebody says, hey, this is the number, round it to 2 digits, so then 6 is more than 5, and this is the one you're dropping, so it becomes 13. If the digit to be dropped is less than 5, the last remaining digit is left as it is. So if you have 12.4 and you want to get rid of 4, because you have to round it to 2 digits, 4 is less than 5, so the answer is 12. Okay? If the digit to be dropped is 5, if any digit following is not 0, the last remaining digit is increased by 1. So if you have 12.51 and you have to round it to 2 digits because you have to drop the 5, 1 is not 0, so this becomes 13. 12.51 becomes 13. If the digit to be dropped is 5 and is followed only by zeros or nothing after that, the last remaining digit is increased by 1 if it is odd, but left as it is if it is even. And, you know, this rule is pretty arbitrary because you want to sort of even out the playing field, right? You don't want to bias the rounding for odd number versus even number. So, for example, if you have 11.5, after 5 there is nothing and you have to round it to 2 digits, you have 5. So you look at the number before the 5, 1, which is odd, so this becomes 12. And if you have 12.5, you have 5, nothing after that. You have 2 here, which is even. This is left as 12. So 11.5 is rounded to 12, but 12.5 is rounded to 12. Okay? This is just an arbitrary rule. Don't round off progressively. So I've seen students making that mistake too. Okay? So if you have, let's say, you know, a 5-6-digit number like this, and you have to round it to only 3 digits, then don't do progressive rounding. Right? So what is progressive rounding? You reduce from 5 to 4, then from 4 to 3. Okay? So if you do that, this is what you will get. So if you round 827.48 to 3 digits in one shot, you look at the number that you're dropping, 4 is being dropped, and since 4 is less than 5, the answer is 827. But if you do progressive rounding, see what happens. You have 827.48, you drop 8. Before 8 is more than 5, so this becomes 827.5. And then again, when you round it, because this is odd, this becomes 828. So the answer is different if you do rounding in one shot. So don't do progressive rounding. Okay, that's something that I've seen students doing, maybe because that's how they learned it before. Exact conversion factors have infinite digits. So exact numbers, if you have exact numbers in a formula, in an expression, if you have exact conversion factors, like 1 meter equal to 100 centimeter, 100 is an exact number. Exact numbers have infinite precision, so they have infinite digits. Okay, so a few examples. So you want to round this to 3 figures. You have 2.3467, and we have to drop the 6 over here. 6 is more than 5, so this becomes 2.35, right? So I'm just going to leave this. You guys can do this when you get home, and I have the answers over here, right? And I will leave this quiz for you guys to work on too, okay? And I'll have the answer in the slides, so you'll be able to look at them. I don't want to spend too much time with the digit stuff.